For number 22, we have 6x over x cubed minus 8. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here and I'm going to look at this x cubed minus 8. And I'm going to think back to algebra. I have the difference of two cubes. What goes in the first parentheses? X squared goes in the second parentheses. That's going to go over there. X minus 2. I just take the cube root of each part, and I keep my original sign. Same, yes. Okay, here's opposite. So what should go right there? Opposite. So this is going to become a plus. Do you remember what goes in the middle? Somebody whispered it. Not 2ab, just ab. So what are we going to have? 2x, okay. What do we know about this last sign? This one is always positive. So remember that we called this soup. Same, opposite, always positive. And what's the last thing? So b squared was negative 2 squared, so that'll be 4. So that is how we factor our denominator here. Calculus is the math class where you're never allowed to forget anything, right? If you've ever learned it anywhere in math, it's going to come back and haunt you in this class. Okay. So this will break up into two fractions. How do I write them? A over x minus 2. Plus c. You can put minus if you want to. You'll work the sign out right. This is an irreducible quadratic, meaning if you tried to do the quadratic formula on it, you'd get complex numbers and not real numbers. All right, we still are going to multiply through by the common denominator. I didn't leave enough room to write it, but... I'm going to put it right here. And this is all really over 1 when I multiply through. So it cancels with the denominators. I wrote it low, so it doesn't really look like that. But on the left side, I'm just going to be left with a 6x. And I get to that A, the x minus 2 factor cancels out. So I'm left with the x squared plus 2x plus 4. When I get to bx plus c, the quadratic factor cancels out. So we're left with x minus 2. So you're just distributing your common denominator throughout the whole equation to clear out your fractions. So we're going to end up with ax squared plus 2ax plus 4a. Plus bx squared minus 2bx plus plus cx minus 2c. So for x squared, we're going to have an ax squared and a bx squared. All right, so that's going to give me a plus b. What's the coefficient of x squared on the left side?
Zero.
Zero, because there is no x squared. All right. Then I have a 2ax, a negative 2bx, and a cx. All of that will go with, that should be 6x, not 6a. All of that will go with this 6x. So what's the equation going to look like?
Is it going just 2a minus 2b plus c equals 6?
Okay. And then what we have left over is this 4a and this minus 2c. And what does that have to equal? Zero. So notice that your first equation relates a and b. Your third equation relates a and c. So what I can do in this case, I mean, there are a lot of ways I could solve it, but it's pretty easy here to say I'm going to let b equal negative a. And here I'm going to say 4a equals 2c, so c could be replaced by 2a. That puts both b and c in terms of a. Now I can rewrite the middle equation with just a in it. Get that written down, and we'll have to go to the next screen. Any questions about anything I've done on this screen? You follow everything? Okay, so our middle equation here was 2a minus 2b plus c equals 6. And we said we could replace b with negative a, and we could replace c with 2a. That puts this whole equation in terms of a. So this would end up being positive 2a, so we would have 6a equal to 6. That means a is going to be 1. If a is 1 and b is equal to negative a, then b will be negative 1. And if c is equal to 2a, then c will be 2. And so now I would like for you to tell me what it is that we are integrating.
1 over x minus 2.
1 over x minus 2. I'm going to go ahead and put a plus here.
And you're
going
to put the negative with the x.
I'm going to put the negative. Yeah, I'm going to put the negative with the x.
Negative x plus 2.
So I'd have a negative x plus 2. And that would be over my other factor, right? So any questions about where this came from? Are we all clear on where this came from? So This one we're going to have to do some manipulating to get it to integrate easily. Because if I tried to do a u substitution, what would my derivative have to be?
2x plus 2.
And that is not what I have. So, here's what I have to think about. I have to think about what to do with that negative x plus 2 to get something that I am able to get a derivative on. And it really is even going to get a little bit worse than that. But let's start with that. So, I'll get back to the integral in a minute. But let's just say I wanted to take negative x plus 2 and try to get x plus 1. And really, you only have the freedom to manipulate the constants. You can't really manipulate the variable. So, if I had negative x minus 1, that would be close enough. So I'm going to write down what I want to have. What I want to have is negative x minus 1. And to compensate for the fact that I subtracted a 1, I'm going to add a 1 back in. And then that plus 2 is still there. So what this really becomes is a negative x plus 1, which is going to get to the form of my derivative. And then I still have this plus 3 left over. So at this point, this one's still okay. I know how to integrate that. I've just created this one. And then this 3 is going to go over here. And I have the same denominator. So now, this I can integrate as a logarithm. This one I can integrate as a u substitution. Now I've got to figure out how to integrate that one. So let's think about that. Yes. Unless you know some other way to integrate them. This to work with. I needed this. Okay. Because my x is negative, and I want my x and my 1 to have the same sign, I just said I'll settle for a negative 1. Because then I can factor out the negative and still have x plus 1. And that would match my du. Okay. So I just stuck the negative 1 there because that's what I wanted to have. But that changed the value of this expression. So if I want to rewrite the expression without changing its value, I can add a 0. So negative 1 plus 1 is 0. And then that plus 2 is still there. And that let me pull out the derivative I needed. Okay. Any guesses as to how we might go about integrating this thing? Let's see if that gets us anywhere. Let's try that. Okay, so I have 3 over x squared plus 2x plus 4. What do I need to complete the square on x squared plus 2x? Okay, and I had a 4, so if I took 1 of it, how much is left? 3. So I could rewrite this then as 3 over x plus 1 squared plus 3. Is that something I would be able to integrate? It's the square of the square root of 3.
Oh.
So that's not a big deal.
Yeah, wouldn't that be a trick substitution? Or
I don't even have to do a substitution.
Or then your U would be x plus 1.
Yeah, it's a regular U substitution, not a trig substitution.
That would be your U squared, and your A would be square root of 3?
Yes. Yeah, but I'm saying you have a regular integral that'll fit this one without having to.
Could you split it
arctangent?
Up?
Arctangent. This is arctangent. No, you can never split up a denominator. So please don't ever do that. Okay. This is just a form of arctangent.
With
a U substitution.
Yeah,
it's
no,
a U
like
substitution.
U squared plus A squared. Yeah, that's
right. So this is just going to integrate to 3 times the arctangent of x plus 1 over 3. Okay, so now we can put it all back together. That one was a lot of work. Y'all did well, though. Okay, so we are integrating 1 over x minus 2. That's going to be our first integral. Our second integral, I'm going to write it this way. I'm going to pull out the 1 half so that I can write 2 times x plus 1 on the top because that's the derivative I needed. And then this one is going to be I'm going to pull the 3 to the outside, and it's going to be 1 over x plus 1 squared. And I'm going to write this as the square root of 3 squared, just so when we take the arctangent, we know where that radical comes from. And now everything is in a form we know how to integrate. What does the first one integrate to? What did I do? Did I mess something up?
Middle term.
I put a 1 half out here so that I could put a 2 here. And that way my derivative matches that I needed. So I compensated for it by sticking a 1 half out front. What's the first term integrate to? This is ln of x minus 2. What about the second one? It's du over u in the second one.
So it's still ln.
It's still ln. So this is 1 half ln of x squared plus 2x plus 4. Okay. And what's our last term integrate to? You can look in the front cover of your textbook at arctangent if you need to. Okay, because normally it would be 1 over A, but we had a 3 out front. And we didn't have limits, so we have to say plus a constant. Okay, so look back over that whole problem and tell me if you have questions anywhere along the way. John, what are you asking me? The sanity calculator?
I'm doing this one.
Oh, okay.
I promise.
All right. You're doing it on the calculator?
I already know how to do this on paper. I'm just trying to learn how to do this.
All right. Well, on your test, I want to see it on paper.
Always.
Okay. All right, any questions about the process here? Any step along the way we need to talk about? This is one of the problems I would have looked at if Dr. Manis was doing it when I was in calculus, and I would go, Dr. Manis, I see exactly what you did. I just never would have thought to do that. And so that's where just integrating and integrating and integrating is where you start to get a feel for how to do a problem like this. I won't put one this complicated on the test because of time constraints. But these are the kind of problems you're going to end up wrestling with later on in engineering and in different short places. So you still need to practice them even if they're not on this test. Besides, if you can do one this long and hard, then the other ones are easier. Okay. I want to look at problem number 42.